Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is John Willoughby, and we are going to do a playthrough of one of my favorite games growing up as a teenager called Grim Fandango. This is the remastered edition that came out a couple years ago. I had the opportunity to play this on the PlayStation 4, and we're going to be doing the PC gameplay. I'm not going to be doing any kind of commentary during the game itself, except maybe in between the different years, and to kind of give a brief little summary upon what happened in that year and the events and why they probably took place. So without any further ado, we're going to go ahead and start a new game. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the...
Sorry for the wait, Mr. Flores. I am ready to take you now.
Take me? Take me where?
Now, now. There's no need to be nervous.
Nervous? No. Just your appearance. It's a little intimidating.
Intimidating? Me? But I'm your friend. My name's Manny Calavera. I'm your new travel agent.
I don't want a new travel agent. I want to go home.
You can't go home, Celso. You're dead. But you're not alone. Everybody here is just as dead as you. That's why we call it the Land of the Dead. Are you ready for your big journey?
No. What journey?
The 4-year journey of the soul. It is quite a big trip. And I can't lie to you, Celso. It could be very, very dangerous. Unless you were to take that money you were buried with and buy a better travel package from us. I mean, wouldn't you rather cross the Land of the Dead in your own sports car? Maybe try a luxury ocean cruise? Or, if you led a very good life, you may even be eligible for a ticket on the number 9 itself.
The number 9?
That's our top-of-the-line express train. It shoots straight to the 9th underworld, the land of eternal rest, in 4 minutes instead of 4 years. But very few people qualify. Let's take a look at your records. Well, the bad news is the train appears to be just out of your reach, but I still got a couple of tricks up my sleeve here. Yaha! Yes, that's the ticket. The Excelsior Line! Yes, she's a beauty. That compass and the handle will sure come in handy, too. Oh, you're going to have a great trip. Wish I was going.
Why don't you? You could give me a lift.
Oh, I can't leave here until I've worked off a little debt to the powers that be.
Community service, eh? Well, I guess there are some folks worse off than me.
Oh, I'll be leaving here soon enough. No thanks to dead and no commission low-life cases like yours, Menso.
Hey, Manny. The boss told me to tell you not to leave early tonight. He wants to talk to you about something when he gets back from his trip.
Tell Don not to worry. I'm not going anywhere. Especially not with clients like that. Where do they get these guys? They don't qualify for anything good, so I can't sell anything good. I can't work off my time, and I'm stuck. Stuck selling walking sticks to a bunch of burros for eternity. I need better clients. I need a real saint. I need a lead on a rich, dead saint. ¿Qué es esto? It's some sort of special work order.
To all agents from office manager Don Copel.
All right, you boneheads! Thank your lucky stars and get to your friggin' cars! We have a mass poisoning on our hands! Too many dead to assign specific cases, so all clients are first come, first serve! So let's see some hustle out there!
Whatever you say, Hiffy.
Better take these cards. It looks like a long day of solitaire for me.
Manny, what are you doing?
Just marking cards, honey. Service!
Hey, who the... Oh, sorry, sir. I didn't expect... Sales agents usually don't come over to this part of the garage.
I'm Calavera. Manny Calavera.
My name's Gladys. I don't get many visitors. Hey, I got a message for a Mr. Calavera. Your driver said that Mr. Hurley said... Then he could have the rest of the day off.
Domino sent my driver home?
Yeah, wasn't that nice?
Looks like I need a new driver.
I would agree with that. Yes, you do.
You want to be my replacement driver?
Me? No. Sorry. Can't. Rules.
Come on, Gladys. I need you to be my driver.
No, I can't. I'm too big.
You're not too big. The cars are just too small.
Yeah, those dang compact cars. Hey, that gives me an idea. I could alter your car just a bit. Just a quick torch job to let out the seams, you know? But I'm not allowed to modify the cars without a work order from upstairs. I could lose my job.
A work order, huh?
Yeah. I can't torch anything bigger than a cigarette without one of these signed by the boss himself.
Hey, that's my line. Getting people to sign. Back in a snap.
Yeah, too small. I'm not too big. Everything around here is just too small.
It's the festival of the Day of the Dead. Really more of a living person's holiday, but since I really didn't get to celebrate the festival this year, I think I'm entitled to a little pan de muertos. I'll just take a little more bread to honor the dead.
Hey, what's going down, clown?
Hey, back off, suit. I'm practicing.
Practicing what?
Wringing your neck. What does it look like?
Some festival, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, pretty busy. My carpal tunnel syndrome's really acting up.
But you don't have any tendons.
Yeah, well, you don't have a tongue. But that doesn't seem to shut you up now, does it?
Could you teach me how to do that?
Well, since you're a beginner, why don't you practice the first step?
Which is?
Blow!
Bang!
Pop another one. Lousy, bony fingers!
Can I walk through your tent? I want to see the parade.
Well, walk through someone else's tent, all right? Do I look like a turnstile to you?
Twist me up one of them, huh, fella?
Yeah. Twist this, all right?
Bet you can't do a cat.
Shows what you know, buddy. I can do anything. I can do birds, amphibians, famous poets. Go ahead, name one.
Robert Frost.
Trying to stump me, eh? Ta-da!
My kid wants another balloon animal.
Jeez, what now?
A dead worm.
Heck, that's easy. There's no limit on those.
My kid wants another balloon animal.
Jeez, what now?
Do you have any more dead worms back there?
Well, sure.
I don't like the way that eye is looking at me. Hello?
It looks like Don's rigged his computer to automatically answer his intercom.
I would love to search Don's office right now, but I'm late for the poisoning.
I'll just change his auto-response here.
Not now, Ava! It'll have to wait! I'm in the middle of a very important meeting! Didn't I say no interruptions today? Whatever it is, it will have to wait! Ava, please! I need a little time alone! Tell him the checks aren't here yet! I'm on the phone! If you buzz me again, I swear I'll jump out this window!
Are you trying to lose your job?
Ah, cripes, Ava! Just sign it yourself, will you? I'm busy!
Eva, I really need the boss to sign this work order.
I'll give it a shot. Mr. Copel, Mr. Calavera has something out here that he says he needs your signature on.
Ah, cripes, Eva! Just sign it yourself, will you? I'm busy!
You'll have to excuse him, Manny. It's probably a really hard crossword puzzle he's got in there today.
Eva, I'm impressed. I had no idea you had this kind of power.
Well, we all have our secrets.
They say black is slimming.
I'm driving, yeah! I'm driving!
Por favor. I could have walked faster than this. Híjole, I'm gonna miss the poisoning.
Domino.
The living still give me the creeps. My scythe. I like to keep it next to where my heart used to be.
Nice bathroom.
But we offer several travel package upgrades if you care to...
Cut the yap! I want something cheap where I can get some rest, and that's it!
Aye, aye, aye.
You know, Manny, I could make this car a little faster, if you wanted.
Yeah, yeah, whatever.
Oh, yeah, slam the front into the weeds, tub the rear end, dual blowers, pop it out of the hood.
You'll get plenty of rest this way, Mr. Martinez, and you'll be safely padded by the foam created when these two chemicals mix, like this.
Oh, on second thought, I want to upgrade my package.
Sorry, Bruno, but you didn't qualify for anything better. But here, have this complimentary mug.
No, wait! Can't you find me something where I can move my legs?
You know I'd like to, Bruno. But my boss is a real hard-ass.
I gotta be a hard-ass when I got lazy sickle wavers like this jolly boy working for me. Manny, you couldn't find a sail at a yacht club.
I got a sail right here.
I'm talking premium sails, Calavera. Like the kind Domino makes.
How am I supposed to make premium sales with the scumbag clients you're sending me?
Hey! Now you're blaming the clients? I've had it with you, Manny. If you haven't bagged a premium before the next sales report comes in, you're out! Out on the street. No job. No way to work off your time. Just your fancy suit and your big smile and a whole lot of time to kill.
Who you calling a scumbag? Why, I ought to...
I'm sick of waiting around for a good lead. Like it's gonna fly in here tied to a brick? It's time to take one.
You and your fancy suits and your nose holes way up in the air, sticking your empty beer bottles down the message tubes. How fancy is that? Huh? Don't you boys upstairs realize the tube switcher is a sophisticated and delicate piece of machinery?
Huh?
You think you're better than me?
No.
Good.
System, do not touch. Hey, you missed a great poisoning.
Yeah, and you missed a great client. Domino came back from there with a nun.
Híjole, I got a tiny little man with a mean temper and no commission.
Well, at least you don't work for one.
I can't find my driver.
Manny, do I have to explain your job to you again?
No, but I like to hear your description of it, just for kicks.
Well, the Manuel Calavera that I know picks up people in the land of the living.
Dead people?
Preferably. And he brings them here and tries valiantly to sell them the best travel package they qualify for. If he sells them enough premium packages, our hero will be free to leave the land of the dead. Until then, he and I are stuck here, having the same conversation over and over again for eternity.
Well, enough about me.
What's your job like?
Like babysitting. Except I don't get to watch TV.
What if we just skip town tonight? You and me, baby.
Well, thanks for the offer, but we'd never make it out of the city alive.
But...
in one piece, I mean.
I bet I could get you out, if I really tried.
Oh, Manny, look at you. You're a trap soul and you don't even know it.
Why do some clients qualify for better travel packages?
They led good lives.
Que traes? How do you define a good life?
Better than yours and mine.
So what did you do in life to get stuck here?
What I did back in the fat days is none of your business. You know the rules.
Just one more question about my job.
Manny, you know what to do. Stop playing dumb just to flirt with me.
Any messages for me?
Besides the one about the poisoning?
Yeah.
I only have one other message for you, Manny. I'm not your secretary. I don't take your messages. So get it through your thick skull and stop forwarding your phone to me.
All right. But that sounded more like four messages to me. In my heart, though, you're still my secretary.
Manny, what are you talking about? I was never your secretary, even when you were on top. I got one boss, same as you, Don Copel.
Come on, I know you work for another man besides Don.
What are you talking about?
I know you take memos for Hurley sometimes.
Ah, Manny, just beat it, will ya?
Busy as ever, I see.
I'd have more work to do if you had more clients.
Ouch. Well, I gotta go hit the bricks.
Okay, you show those bricks a lesson.
Look out below. Well, at least you're not hitting the bottle anymore.
Hey, Kelly, how you doing?
I want to tell you something.
Good. Go on and let it all out, Manny. There's no reason for you to be afraid of me.
I think you're up to something.
Yeah, I'm up to about 4 premium sales this week.
I think we should team up. Be partners.
Oh, Manny, I would, but I'm too intimidated. I could never be partners with someone who was so much more of a man than me.
Oh, come on. I've seen your wife. You know, this used to be my office.
Yeah, I know. I found your name on some comic books in the desk.
I want my office back.
Don't worry, you'll have years and years to enjoy it after I get promoted out and you're still here.
So, how'd you make out of the poisoning?
Well, let's just say that Sister Calabaza has a secret passion for trains.
You got a nun?
Hail Mary.
And you sold her a ticket on the number 9 train.
Choo-choo, little buddy. Say, how'd you score?
I got a mean midget I had to send parcel post.
Ah, cheer up, buddy. Another day, another death. Am I right?
I want to punch you in the mouth.
Oh, no, not the Christmas party all over again.
What happened at the Christmas party?
Blacked out on the whole thing, huh? Maybe you should switch to lemonade, kid.
I want to ask you a question.
Shoot, slugger.
Is it hard to kiss up to the boss so much when you got no lips?
Hey, I got all the lip I need. I get it from you.
Can I have one of your clients?
Sure, Cal. Just as soon as I get what I think you could handle.
I can handle anything you got, especially if that's your best right jab.
Why do you get all the good clients?
You're asking the wrong guy. You should be taking a good long look at the man in the mirror.
No, thanks. I don't enjoy that the same way you do. What did you do to get this job?
You mean what's my secret to success?
No, I mean how did you screw up and get stuck here at the DOD? What sin did you commit and how long are you gonna have to work here to pay it off?
Well, I could easily ask the same question of you.
But I don't know the answer. I still don't know what I've done.
Well, how convenient. Then, neither do I.
Well, you sound pretty out of breath, so I'm gonna blow.
Always a pleasure, Cal.
That's some premium-looking scotch.
Have some, Manny. Just so you don't forget what premium tastes like.
Server's down again.
What else is new? Symbolically compelling.
Hi, I'm not getting any messages. Is the server down?
This is their idea of a joke? They think it's funny? I'd like to jam their tubes with packing material. See how they like that.
Can I squeeze in there just for a sec?
Are you kidding? This is a highly secured area. No one's allowed in here who ain't me.
So you're saying the server is down, is that it?
The server is not down. It's never down. It's just temporarily unavailable while I'm doing some maintenance, that's all.
So how long is it gonna be down?
With a job like this, you can never tell. Probably hours.
Or until no one's around to see you sneak out, eh?
Whichever comes first.
You know, I really think it's clean enough.
Oh, it's clean enough to run, all right. I'm just fiddling around to be safe. You know, gotta cover my ass.
Yes, you do. What's so special about you?
I, sir, am an elemental spirit, summoned from the land of the dead itself.
Yeah, let me guess. You were given one purpose, one skill, one desire. Fixing pneumatic tube switchers.
No, I was created to run the elevators, but they put in those dang motion detectors and put me out of work.
Who would do a terrible thing like this?
It's those punks in the mailroom. They think this baby is going to put them out of a job. And they're right.
Just curious, how'd you get in there?
I squeezed down one of these tubes like a pixie. How do you think I got in here? Through the door, just like you. Say, Chatty Cathy, I got a lot of tubes to flush here.
Hey, me too. I'll let you go.
Oh, not again. You trying to blow this joint sky high? That's a magnesium compound fire extinguisher. Spray that on this packing foam and we'll both be riding the giant Roman candle out of here.
What? Why would they put something so dangerous in here?
I guess they didn't expect this room to be full of hazardous waste. Good enough for government work.
Mercedes Colomar, client number 9308, blah, 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 died of chickenpox, time of death, yada, yada, yada. Aha, positive attributes, volunteer time, reading stories to dying children. That's good. That's really good. I think you're it, Mercedes Colomar. I think you're the one for me. Pilates. Are you loco? What got into you? That was a company car.
Oh, yeah. And it's even better company now. Hop in.
Buenos días.
You're not the nurse?
No.
You're not here to give me my medication?
No, but I am here to ease your pain.
Guess they couldn't save me, huh?
No, but there's still a chance you could save me.
That's a lot of responsibility, Mr. Calavera. What makes you think I've been all that good?
Miss Colomar.
Meche, please.
Meche, I can see it in your face and in your file here, where it says you're entitled to a first-class ticket to... Nowhere? What?
Did I do something wrong?
Not according to your bio. It was spotless. At least the part I read was.
I'm not sure I like the implication, Mr. Calavera.
Are you sure you're Mercedes Colomar?
Yes. Would you like to see my birthmark?
Sure. Where is it?
It's wherever you guys put my skin.
Anything about your past you haven't told me?
Quite a bit, considering I've told you nothing.
Did you kill much when you were alive?
Very little.
Never killed anybody?
I have to confess, I never killed anybody.
Not even a teensy bit of killing?
Maybe I just wasn't trying hard enough.
Were you a big shoplifter?
Well, they accused me of it once.
Really?
But it wasn't my fault. That puppy followed me out of the store.
Oh. Mean to animals?
Oh no, I love animals. Once, when I was volunteering at an animal shelter, I...
Just stop right there. Ever cheated on your taxes?
I've never paid taxes in my life.
Aha!
I've never made enough money to be taxed. You know, it's mostly been all volunteer work.
Uh-huh. Ever cheated on your husband?
Mr. Calavera, there's no ring on my finger.
There's no skin on it either.
I guess you'll just have to trust me then.
Litter?
Oh, Manny, is that the best you can do?
Work with me, Meche. Give me some dirt.
Well, I could do something bad right now, if that would help.
Wouldn't count. Sorry, I give up.
Don't say that, Manny.
Excuse me, but I have to go straighten this mess out.
Sorry to be so much trouble, Mr. Calavera.
It's no trouble, but please, call me Manny.
I'm sorry I let you down, Manny.
Hey, Funny Bones! In my office! Now! You vandalized company property in order to obtain secret information so you could take your illegally modified company car and your unregistered driver and run Domino here off the road! All in order to steal a client from her legitimate agent!
There's nothing legitimate about this place. You give all the good clients to Domino.
Manny, now I'm embarrassed for you.
You've embarrassed the whole office. I'm going to call the woman in here so you can apologize to her yourself. Ava, send in Ms. Colomar, please.
She left about 15 minutes ago, sir. She said she had a long walk ahead of her and she wanted to get started.
Walking? She had a ticket on the number 9! Why does she think she has to walk?
That's the best package I could find for her.
Now you see why I give all the good clients to Domino! That woman was a saint and a shoo-in for a double-end ticket that she's not going to get because you just couldn't find it! And now, because of your little stunt, she's out there! On her own, walking by herself through the petrified forest, facing the demons of the underworld, alone and unprotected! This is her reward after a lifetime of hardship and public service? Her destiny stolen by some overreaching salesman looking for a fat commission he didn't deserve! Get in there and stay put until the boys downtown tell us what they want done with you. Someone's gonna take the fall for this, Calavera, and it ain't gonna be me!
Hey, anybody out there?
So, Manuel, have you thought about what you have done?
Who's out there?
I'm you. Or rather, I was you. years ago.
Yeah, well, I'm me now, so get lost. Get me out of here.
The only way out, Manuel, is to be taken back in. If you are truly still loyal to this company, declare it loudly. The management might hear and stick you right back in their fold.
The DOD runs a crooked game, and I intend to prove it.
You would do that? That could cause this agency a lot of trouble.
I'm gonna blow the lid off this place.
Young man, you are an enemy of the Department of Death.
Welcome to the club. Salvador Limones and guest.
Where are you taking me?
To the headquarters of the LSA.
LSA?
The Lost Souls Alliance. We're a small group, Manuel. We're always looking for new soldiers.
To do what exactly?
We need help in our intelligence unit. You know Eva, of course.
Manny?
I was once a reaper like yourself, Manuel. But I uncovered a web of corruption in our beloved Department of Death. I have reason to believe that the Bureau of Acquisitions is cheating the very souls it was chartered to serve. I think someone is robbing these poor, naive souls of their rightful destinies, leaving them no option but to march on a treacherous trail of tears, unprotected and alone. Like babies, Manuel. Like babies.
What's your evidence?
That's where you come in, Manuel. Or should I call you Agent Calavera?
Manny suits me fine. I'm not looking to join any military organization, Sal. I just want my job back so I can work off my time and get out of this dump.
Well, you won't even be able to get out of this city without my help. Which means, of course, you won't be able to find that woman and you'll never get your job back. When you're ready to join the cause, Manuel, come talk to me. We might be of some use to each other.
So you're not really a secretary.
I'm a spy, Manny.
Well, that's the last time we use that temp agency. Any messages for me?
Yes. Join or die.
But I'm already...
Again!
Eva, you gotta get me out of town. They're gonna sprout me.
You can't leave, Manny. We need access to the DOD computer network if we're ever gonna find out what's going on. And we can't access without a salesman like you. The computer IDs you when you log on.
How does it do that? Fingerprints? I don't have any.
Your teeth, Manny. Haven't you ever noticed your computer scanning your teeth when you log on?
I thought that was just a power surge.
We need your teeth, Manny. We can't let you go. Sorry.
Doesn't Cabal wonder where you are?
Don and Domino are both locked up in Don's office with some bigwig from downtown. Some fatty in a fez.
Who is the fat man, I wonder? And how does he fit into this sinister puzzle?
How long have you been a spy?
Salvador recruited me about a year ago. I couldn't resist him. He's just so noble.
What are you working on there?
I'm trying to get this radio working so we can use it in the field. But it looks pretty hopeless. Salvador's right. We need good old-fashioned homing pigeons to communicate with our field agents.
You have field agents?
No, it's just Sal and me right now. But someday, Manny.
So, you won't help me out of here?
Sorry. I'll help you out, but not your teeth. Think it over.
Open that door, Sal. I got places to go.
Does that mean you're ready to join us?
Okay, I'm in. What do I have to do?
I'm going to build an underground army of souls to fight the injustice I have seen in El Marro. Communication will become vital as the Lost Souls Alliance spreads out. We'll need messengers we can trust.
You want me to be your messenger?
No, Manuel. Our numbers are small and our agents are too valuable to risk that sort of work. History shows only one messenger to be of use to a cause like ours. Carrier pigeons.
If I grab some pigeons off the roof, will you let me go?
No. I need to raise them from birth, Agent Calavera. I need you to bring me their eggs.
You're keeping me here because you need the eggs?
Why are you still here, Calavera? Go get me an Air Force before it hatches.
I'm off.
Farewell, Agent Calavera. And viva la revolución!
Thank you.
The drapes are drawn. Dom and Don must still be in there. Dom's office is empty. Ugh, Domino had this in his mouth. What the? There's something glowing in there. It looks like a glowing hunk of coral. Nothing else in there. No messages in Dom's fancy red tube. I'm gonna try to guess his password. It's not Golden Boy. I'm gonna try to guess his password. And it's not Mr. D either. So much for Dommy. Harrigan fraud doesn't work. Whew, I was scared it might be Eva. Well, he likes boxing too, but that ain't it. Not greed. Not vanity. Not sleaze. I give up. I wonder if that's how Domino meant it to be used. The looks of those pigeons.
Hey!
Ah, the pigeons obviously like this dish vent. Maybe that will scare them. Eventually.
Those little ledge pickers.
You must come with me, young ones, for I am the Green Reaper.
Thank you.
Hey, what did they do with Gladys? Ooh, ick. It came out like soft serve ice cream, but judging by the smell, I think it's auto body filler. Philodent. Good for dents, great for dentures. Wow, that made a perfect impression of my teeth and a quite a chalky aftertaste too. Agent Calavera and two guests.
This looks like a perfect impression of your teeth. We can use this as a mold to make a fake set of teeth and get into the computer system that way.
Good work, soldier. Check these babies out.
Excellent, Manuel. With these, I can breed an entire army of winged messengers. Our revolution can spread now across the land, carried on the shimmering wings of justice. Thanks to you. Agent Calavera, you are a friend of the revolution, Agent Calavera. And now, let me be of service to you.
You must go to the town of Rubacaba, my friend, if you want to find your lost soul.
How do you know where she is?
I don't, but everyone who wants to get to the Ninth Underworld must cross the Sea of Lament, and therefore must go to Rubacaba to get passage on a ship. As long as you get there before she does, you'll find her. But it may be quite a wait.
I'll wait as long as it takes.
Manuel, are you in love with her?
Love? Love is for the living, Sal. I'm only after her for one reason. She's my ticket out of here. That was some tunnel. I'm all the way to the edge of the petrified forest. That Salvador really knows how to do this espionage thing with style. Gladys, my friend, why are you crying?
Manny? Oh, Manny, they fired me!
Me too, buddy.
You don't understand, Manny. I was created just to do that job. It's the only thing that makes me happy. It's like they reached into my chest and pulled out my heart and threw it into the woods to...
Gladys, what have you done? Oh, Gladys. I wonder how long he can live without a heart. Oh, no. Ooh, ick. Shoot! I guess I could always use a spare. Soup's on! Huh. They don't seem very interested in that bone I put in there. Oh, poor spiders. No more demon heart to eat.
It's still beating.
Heart! Heart is good. Be good to heart. Don't tear out heart. Heart is good. Strong, beating, good heart.
Hey, is that my car?
Mr. Lamont, I assure you the missing woman will be found. I will personally track her down myself.
Just like you personally picked her up from the land of the living?
That was my intention, but Agent Calavera somehow got to her first.
We gave you the fastest car, Domino. We gave you all the best clients. You had all the advantages. So how was this Calavera able to sneak in there and eat your lunch?
Oh, now, Hector, you can't get too mad at Domino. That wasn't his fault.
Oh, I can, Don. You should know I can get too mad. But not at Domino. After all, he wasn't in charge of this operation. At least, not until now.
Hector, no!
Marigolds. Funny. For some reason, I was expecting tulips. Well, maybe Mr. Calavera, eh, Domino? Why don't you personally go down to the basement and escort him up here? The sooner he's sprouted and we can get back to business, the better.
Wanna go for a ride?
I thought you'd never ask!
Híjole, mano. What sort of unholy Christmas tree farm is this, Gladys? Gladys?
Manny, check out this wheelbarrow, will ya? With a couple of ATV nubby tires on the back and a two-stroke lawnmower engine, we could make one sweet go-kart.
Gladys, what are they doing to that tree?
Oh, city boy! You work all day in a 60-story skyscraper, but didn't you ever wonder what it was made of? The marrow of these trees, man. They suck it out. It's like cement.
Is that why the town's called El Marrow?
Huh? Never thought of that. Maybe so.
Manny?
With the harmonic balancer turned off, those pumps might shake that tree apart.
Oh, but... Oh!
If we shook the tree down, those pumps would dislodge, and I could make high-lift shots out of them for the bone wagon. Hold on. I'm going to unbalance that wheel with some of these weights. That'll shake it down for sure. Okay, just give me a second to balance these doggies. Hey, Manny! What are you doing?
Manny, until now we scraped along the ground like rats. But from now on we soar. Like eagles. Yeah. Like eagles on pogo sticks!
What a relief. I was getting concerned that our transportation wasn't ostentatious enough.
Get in, or are you afraid of heights? Scared of that sign.
It looks like some sort of warning sign. They'll tear you apart, bone by bone, and build with you a human throne. Their buck-tooth king will sit upon what once was you, but now is gone. This key unlocks the gates of hell. Steady traveler, use it well. Pass up an old creepy key.
Don't you know what's on the other side of that gate?
Yeah, the way out of the forest.
Demon beavers, Manny! They'll make you into a dam!
Relax, Geppetto. I'm not made of wood.
But Manny!
They don't use wood.
Thank you.
This river seems to be made of tar, but those beavers just seem to cut through it like water. That road leads out of the forest, I'm sure, but I don't think I'd get very far on foot. Plus, how could I leave without Gladys? This outer gate is huge. I'll need Gladys to open it.
Manny, I don't know if I like driving over people.
They can't feel it, they're dead.
You're dead? I wouldn't want to drive over you.
That's because you and I, Gladys, are friends.
Aw, Manny.
The racket, the whole town's asleep.
But I want a drag race. When they get a load of my car, we're gonna be the talk of the town.
You're right. We're gonna have to find a good place to hide that road show. Speaking of hiding, I wonder if Mech is here already. I'm gonna go see what I can stir up. Not a bad piece of real estate, actually. It's got potential. All these doors have numbers and pictures of food on them. What's number 22?
Lengua.
Wow. It's been a long time since I had a tongue.
Mr. Flores, I'm ready to take you now.
Manny Calavera. Is that you? Didn't you used to be taller?
What are you doing here?
Well, if you must know, it's about my wife. I got word that she passed away not long after I, and that she too was crossing the land of the dead on foot. It is said that all lost souls come to Rubacava, so I came here to wait for her.
You must love her very much, Celso.
Yes, this is true. Of course, she also has all of my money.
How do you know your wife hasn't gone ahead of you?
Oh, Manny. If she had arrived here first, surely she would have waited for me.
I'll help you find your wife. What did she look like?
Oh, here. I got this from the DOD and made copies to hand out.
Isn't she something? She must have been beautiful with skin.
Weren't we all?
Well, I'd better go see how my other clients are doing.
If you say so, Manny.
Watch your step around here, stranger. Rubacava ain't the quaint little port town she used to be. Well, hell, looks like there's a new vessel in town. Pardon me whilst I go check her out.
Well, actually, it's mostly stock with a few mods here and there.
So, would those be glass packs I'm hearing, or turbos?
ever seen this woman?
Oh, if this is the woman you're looking for, take my advice. Forget about her. She sailed out of here weeks ago in a cozy portside cabin built for two. And she wasn't alone.
Well, don't let me interrupt your car talk.
Look, I know how you feel, son. Once I lost a very special lady myself. I waved to her from the docks as she sailed out of port, and I never saw her again.
What was her name?
The SS La Mancha was her name, but don't make me talk about her, because I just can't do it.
There was this one high-pitched whine it was making, really grating noise, you know? And I searched and searched, but I couldn't find the source of the noise until we pulled in here.
Was it the blower?
No, it was Manny screaming in the back like a cat tied to a cruise missile.
That's a good one.
Hola.
Hey, Manny, Dock Master Velasco here says he's got a place we can dry dock the bone wagon for a while.
Oh, yeah. We can't leave a beauty like this out in the fog, or her chrome will get pitted.
Pitted? Did you hear that, Manny?
Are you folks gonna stay in Rubicava for a spell?
How do you know she sailed out of here? I don't believe it.
It's a tough break, Junior, but you gotta face it. Here, look it up in my port log if you want it in writing. 6 weeks ago on a Tuesday. Ticket for two, paid in full. I cracked the champagne on the bow myself.
Well, don't let me interrupt your car talk.
Ah, yeah, where was I? Oh, yeah, so anyway...
Celso, your wife sailed out of here 2 months ago with another man. It's all in there.
Oh, Manny. Is there a greater constant in nature than the treachery of women?
Forget about her, Celso.
Have you forgotten yours? I'm going after her. You take over my job here. This mop, at least, will never let you down.
That compass in the handle will sure come in handy, too.
That brings a conclusion upon year one out of year four of Grim Fandango. As we have learned, Manny Calavera is our main character. His job is working for the Department of Death, otherwise known as the DOD, trying to sell travel packets to the new incoming dead from the land of the living upon their death. If they led a good life or buried with a lot of money, they can buy premium travel packages. Such as tickets on the number 9, which is a train that will lead them straight from the land of the dead into the ninth realm, the land of eternal rest, in 4 minutes instead of 4 years. And along the way, he met Glottis, which is a demon that was summoned by the underworld itself to act as a mechanic. He also met Salvador Leon, who is the leader of the resistance, the LSA, the Lost Souls Alliance. And he found out that Ava, who was Don Capal's secretary, was also a member of the LSA as well. Currently, if you include Manny, there'd be 3 members of the LSA. But really, Manny's not looking to join the LSA, so right now there's only 2. Right now, he's trying to look for the woman who might be able to help him prove that there's a crooked... nature and twist behind the Department of Death, screwing people out of their rightful claims to their afterlife, and they're just rewards for the good lives they led, and he's currently looking for a woman named Mercedes Karma. She's also referred to as Meche. He spent the entire time, once he found out about the betrayal with the Department of Death, up until now when he arrived in the town of Rubicava, trying to find this woman. And we also found out that, along with the crookedness going on in the land of the dead with the Department of Death, we have Don Capel, who was both Manny's and Domino's boss, was in charge of that office. And we found out that he was involved, as well as Domino, in ripping these people off from their rightful claims to their sweet life rewards. And apparently, we now learn that there's another man involved, a fat guy with a fez. So we're going to go ahead and conclude this video here. Hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to stay tuned in the next couple days for year 2 of Grim Fandango Remastered.